At first glance, techno and humour don't really appear to fit together. However, Detroit's homegrown Kenny Larkin did actually start off as a stand-up comedian, but that was before embarking on his journey into the techno scene at the end of the 80s. It was the widely acclaimed albums he went on to release on Warp, R&S and Peace Frog that won him international recognition. Some of his best buddies include Carl Craig, who released Kenny's most recent and dancefloor-compatible album to date, Keys, Strings and Tambourines, on his label Planet E. But Kenny has not lost touch with the comedian in him and continues to work hard on his career in comedy. His other interests include modern architecture and photography.
Many people ask me, why do you do so many photographs of yourself, or why do you go what do you like to photograph? I don't know. Whatever catches my eye when I'm photographing myself is just because I'm being silly and stupid. Excuse me. I like to photograph myself in different situations. And then also, like, if I'm not photographing buildings or anything like that, it could be something that repeats that I find interesting, like columns or something like that, or even the shapes of things. I'm more of a visceral person. When I'm visual and I see shapes and stuff and it tugs at you on the inside, who knows why? Why do people grow up liking the color black or blue, or who knows? But I've had this thing inside of me since I was a kid, so I just grab pictures of whatever I think is interesting. There's a commonality between art and taking pictures and music and everything for me. And that common thing is chaos. I think when you start approaching any of those things with some type of formula, you lose the art. You lose the whole vibe of the whole thing that you're trying to do. So when I do music, people, like some guy asked me the other day, well, how do you do music? Well, I just sit down and I do music. I don't like start with a drum beat, start with a hi-hat. That's not my style. Who knows, I'm in this big field right now and I can see a pipe and it goes curvy and whatever. If it strikes me inside, I'll take a picture of it. If I'm working at the keyboard, I'm working on a melody. If it strikes me, I'll start there. If not, I'll start with strings. Who knows, it's always something different every time. And I think that's the way you keep it fresh and interesting. There's two things to me that music, that transcends race, language, cultures, everything. There's music, because you don't have to have lyrics to speak to people. You can do it through music. You can do it through music. It's fantastic to be able to go to Russia or Croatia and you don't speak one lick their language. They don't speak the same of yours other than hello, and then you rock the house and then they're just moved by something on the inside. And humans have those two things, music, and then I think it's smell. Smell can take you, if you smell the flower, it can take you back 20 years to where you first smelled the flower. And music is the same. You can hear a song and it'll take you back instantly to when you were a kid and you were playing with your parents and you had these good times. So it's really cool to have those things that like kind of play with your brain a little bit and kind of make you live a little bit more loosely, as opposed to straight and analytical and, well, it has to be this way. It's just, it never works like that. I've always been that kind of person where I've worked from the heart with music. Now, that there's downsides to that. Well, some people think there's downsides, which is I serve my artistry more than what people might like. In other words, if I have a ton of songs, I'll pick the songs for an album that I like, not that I think other people will like. So then people think, his music is too weird, or I can't understand it, or we can't play this in the club because it's not, pumping enough or whatever. But I pick stuff that I like and stuff that rings true to me and what I'm about. And there's no formula or contract to it. It's just chaos. It's just blah. It's just there. It's like an amoeba. it pumps and it grows and it just. And it's on its own free will. It's just how it's supposed to be.
You are God in the physical body. You are spirit of the flesh. You are cosmic being. You are all power. You are all wisdom. You are all intelligence. You are perfection.
My new album is called Keys, Strings, Tambourines, and you might guess what the main part of the album is: keys, strings, and tambourines, in that order, actually. And it's a project I worked on for probably a year and a half, maybe. And it's coming out on Carl Craig's label, Planet E. And it's a continuation of my sound, but it's more pumping, it's more clubby. So I'm typically not the kind of guy who goes and does a lot of club tracks. So I just do stuff that kind of I feel, and it usually ends up being stuff that you listen to at home. But this one is a little bit different. It's a bit more. But also, I wrote a couple of these tracks in different cities and countries, like in Sydney and some other countries. So it's cool to be able to go to those other different cities and get different inspiration. You draw different inspiration off whatever your surroundings is. I'm one of those guys. I get inspiration from my surroundings. So I think it's probably one of my best. I mean, I would say that. I mean, but everybody's gonna say that. The latest is their best, right? I'm not gonna dog my shit, right? It sucks. Don't buy it. No, I think it's one of my best. I mean, and I'll tell you why I think that. It's because Carl is so critical of what he releases on his label. So this is the first album he's released in a long time. Full-length album on his label. So, and he really likes it. So, I mean, that gives me the confidence enough to say, oh, yeah. And then also everybody's, the people that I've given the songs to, they're playing them a lot, like Derek and a lot of these guys at the clubs. And I'm like, it's always shocking for me to hear my own shit in clubs. Like, I will never play my stuff. You come up to me and say, play your own stuff, I'm going to be like, fuck you, man. I'll let other people do that. I'm too shy to play my own stuff. I'll let y'all play that. Am I babbling? I talk a lot. I'm sorry. I've always been one of those kind of kids when I was little to have a sense of self. I don't know if you know what that means. Like self, a strong sense of self. Like I know who I am, that kind of thing. And self-esteem and like strong character. And so I was always, since I was a little kid, always able to say no to stuff that was offered me as I was a kid. So it was easy for me to grow up and not take any drugs or a lot of alcohol. I mean, I don't drink alcohol. I drink a glass of wine every now and then, but I don't drink it regularly. I don't do drugs. Never been high. Never been none of that shit. That's just not my thing. I'm silly enough. I don't need. People usually drink to get all crazy. I'm crazy enough, so I don't really need. I'd be in jail somewhere with my ass in the air, probably getting. Yeah, okay. that's a joke. I ain't gay. I'm telling you. I'm just one of those guys I've never been influenced by peer pressure. Like friends, they try to influence you and push you into doing shit. I've never been into that. Now I know other people in my life that they fall right for that shit. They take whatever people give them or offer them, and it's because they don't have a strong sense of who they are and what they can say no to. I don't give a shit. I can say I don't care if it's the biggest person, the most popular, and they offer, I'd be like, no, I don't do this shit. No, come on, man, no, get the fuck out my face. I don't do this shit. That's how I am. So kids, don't do it. Just cause somebody tell you to. The best things about being in Detroit when the start of this Detroit techno happened was because it was out of chaos. They didn't know what they were doing. They just were doing music. They didn't sit in a room a week ago and go, you know what, we're going to start a new music. They didn't do that. And it was a really cool time to be in that, to be around for a birth of a genre of music. You don't really see that often. And that goes to the chaos thing I was talking about. It's just like this really weird I get shivers talking about it. It was really cool to be around that. So yeah, so comedy, music is not going anywhere. I mean, obviously, if I get big in the comedy stuff, I'm sorry. Music gonna have to, like, you know, I'm gonna have to sit that down for a minute. But I'm here to do different things, not just one thing. I don't want to DJ until I'm 56. I don't want to do techno music until I'm 62. Let me grow, please. I want to do everything. My plan is to have a lot of babies, and I'm an old man now. I'm trying to start a family, but career-wise, I want to kind of go into the direction of acting and comedy acting, and maybe making some comedy films. See, I believe in myself. You got to believe that you can do this shit. Yeah, and I have some friends out and writing partners out in LA that we're kind of putting some stuff together now. So I'm gonna kind of still go that way, and I'm not gonna finish doing music until everything else is set up with the comedy stuff. So don't hate me. I want to do something different with my life. You grow up from the dance music, you go, okay, that was fun, now it's the next step. So